So in the last example, when we were looking at that ball game, there was one thing which we were doing is that I have to did an experiment with so number of pepper, right? And we got based on those numbers, we got the probabilities and all that. But it's not always possible to do these sort of experimentations. Can I solve the same problem without doing any sort of experimentation? Yes, you can do that. So now we're gonna learn that technique that how to do that, because a lot of times we may not have the time to do experiment or number of people to do sample of experiment. Secondly, maybe I don't have enough data to do that experiment. And so many things can be possible. So let's see how to do that. So in this case, we're gonna learn about something called as binomial distribution. Now in this binomial distribution case, what really happens? If you do remember, I have three red balls and two blue balls, right? If I'm not wrong, that was the case. So here, if you remember at the initial part, so we had gone till x is equal to 4. In fact, let me come back here quickly. Okay. So if you can recall, there were three red balls and basically there were total of five balls. So what is the probability that I will get one red ball out of a trial? Now, since my thing was that I have three red balls and two blue balls, so there were total five balls, out of which three balls are possible to be a red ball. So my probability comes out to be 0.6. In probability, there is a very interesting multiplicative theorem which states that if I have two events and if I want to have an AND condition for it, like P probability of event one should happen as well as event two should happen, then that is equivalent to stating that probability of event one into probability of event two. How can I use this on this particular example? Let's see that. So for this, let's say I want the probability now that I want two red balls in two trials. That means the first time I pull up a ball, I should get red. Second time I pull up the ball, I should again get red. Okay, that is the probability I want. So in this case, it becomes like probability of red I get in the first trial into probability of red in the second trial. This is again with the multiplication rule. So probability of getting red in the first trial is 0.6. Probability of getting red in the second trial, because we have put that ball back, right? So again, this is going to be 0.6. So total probability is going to be 0.36 in this case. Now, a question for you. What about if I have two blue balls and three red balls, and I want to get an output like this, one blue ball first and then three red balls. So how you can get that? So this probability of blue ball is going to be 2 divided by 5, which is 0.4. And for the red balls, I will have 3 divided by 5, which is 0.6. And this is going to be the total probability for this condition, right? So I hope you are able to solve that. Let's go ahead. Now what I'm going to do, if you look at my example, so this is the probability which I'm going to get when I got in the first time one blue ball and remaining I got all the three red balls. This is basically I'm solving for p x is equal to 3, right? That is what we are trying to solve. So here my for this blue color it's going to be 2 by 5 as we learned. For red color I will have 3 by 5, 3 by 5, 3 by 5. I multiply all of that, I will get this number. Now if my combination is little different like this, like I got the first red ball, then blue ball, then two red ball, then I'm going to get this. Similarly, I may get this sort of combination, I will get this. I may have this number of combination, I will get this. So when my PX is 3, I had four combination possible, and for each combination, I will have same probability. So what I have to do for PX is equal to 3, let me add all this one. So 4 into 0.0864, which will end up with 0.3456. Let's do the same thing on the remaining, but before that, let's understand one additive rule also, which we have applied earlier. If I have two events and there's an OR gate there, then I have to do an addition. Okay, so that is an additive rule in formula. Now, the same thing for PX is equal to 1. I would strongly recommend you to now go back and solve this on your own. So, P is equal to X is equal to 1. So here it is going to be again four possibilities were there and I got this probability. Similarly for x is equal to 0, there was only one possibility and basically x is equal to 0 means all the blue balls. So I got like 0.04 because the blue ball probability, and I did a square and I get this. Same way I get for x is equal to 2. So where there were two blue ball and two red ball, I will get this probability. Similarly, x is equal to 4, I will have basically only one possibility here and I will get this probability. Let's go ahead. Let's plot it just like how we were doing it in the previous experiments. I plot it and when I plotted it, the graph looks like this. This is very similar to what I basically have got when I did an experiment. Yes, definitely it's not exactly similar, but if you look at the trend, this is going to look almost very similar to what we have got. So this is the way you can actually perform your experiment basically without any experimentation. So you can easily get all these probabilities in this manner. Okay.